people in the grave, can they listen to what's going on in the world? Because it's said that three things go to the people in the grave: the good deeds, the wealth, and the people. And after that, they can hear the footsteps in the grave, then the punishment starts. And also, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, does he know what's going on in the grave, what's going on in the world till the Qiyamah?
If I have a question of this nature, where should I look for the answer? It's a very important question. And is anyone and everyone qualified to just give me an opinion and say, oh yeah, you know what, they can hear you, so you can go there and sit and have a chat with your uncle and say, uncle, you know what, auntie's troubling me a lot, and so on. Really, people think that, you know, the dead, perhaps they can hear everything and so on. The truth is, the only answers that are accurate are the answers given to us by Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as you correctly mentioned the hadith of the dead hearing the footsteps of those who have come to bury and so on, the truth is, we know that when a person dies, the functions, the worldly functions of these organs is complete and over. Now it's connected to Allah, a different form and a different way. Allah allows them to hear certain things and does not allow them to hear certain things. So, like the footstep, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said clearly that, okay, the footsteps are heard, we believe the footsteps are heard. According to us, the footsteps are heard because the hadith says that, and we stop there. Similarly, when we say, assalamu alaykum ahl al-diyari min al-mu'minina wal-muslimin, wa inna insha'allahu bikum lalahiqun, the narration says, they hear that. How they hear it, I don't know. Allah says they hear it. So now someone says, well, if they can hear the salam, why can't they hear everything else? Why can't I go and talk to them? The reason is, have you owned a radio? So you'll understand, the radio has so many stations you can tune to. So many stations you can tune to. But you tune to one. When you tune to one, you can only hear what's on that one. No matter what's happening on all the other ones, you cannot hear them. So whatever's according to a certain tune on a certain frequency, you can hear it. That is explained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hadith. So if I go and I say, assalamu alaykum ahl al-diyari min al-mu'minina wal-muslimin, it's on a certain frequency. But the minute I start going and I start speaking about, hey, you know, your son is troubling me, people do this. That's ignorance. And people start asking questions to say, you know, I need help, and you know, I really need you to assist me, guide me, and so on. All that is disallowed. So one might say, well, how is it disallowed? Say, look, it's the wrong frequency altogether. That's my way of explaining it. So it's there in the hadith, as you said, the khashkhasha, and you know, the ni'al, slippers or the sandals and whatever, you know, is heard, the footsteps, so to speak. And at the same time, the salam. And as for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith makes it quite clear that ما من أحد يسلم علي إلا ورد الله روحي فأرد له السلام. Anyone who has greeted me, Allah returns the ruh to, and I respond to the salam. How exactly that's done, I don't know. It's not explained to us. I believe exactly that, and I stop at that. And he responds to the salam. But does that give me the right to start talking about so many other things and complaining? We would stop exactly where that hadith stopped, to say, you know what? You go, you do read the salam, you follow the way the Sahaba radiallahu anhum did it, and that's what happens. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Jazakallah khair, my brother.